Australia's international migrant intake will soar to record heights this year, with 400,000 people predicted to enter the country. The opposition is fanning fears the influx will worsen the housing market, but business groups say more needs to be done to make migration easier.
Soaring to new heights, Australia's net international migration is forecast to reach a record 400,000 arrivals this year, according to a leaked cabinet brief, but the opposition isn't giving it a thumbs up.
The government has no plan to address it. They have no housing plan. They have no rental plan. They have no congestion plan.
Half the influx will be international students, which the government says will have less of an impact on the housing market. Anouk Darling is the CEO of Scape, purpose-built student accommodation. She says each student spends nearly $4,500 per month on discretionary purchases.
We need migration and we need these students. We need the students to come and learn and live and hopefully to stay as well and continue to contribute to Australia's future.
If we look at net overseas migration throughout history, World War I, the Great Depression and World War II saw more people leave than arrive. But overall, it's been steadily on the rise since then, until the COVID pandemic caused another deep plunge. Now it's projected to peak this year.
Earlier this week, the Home Affairs Minister announced an overhaul of the migration system, a move welcomed by business groups who say more skilled migrants are needed to fill gaps in the labour market.
Housing, hospitality, construction, manufacturing, mining, all of these areas are really struggling to get the people that they need.
Paris Martin for 10 News First.